Next kind of problems we're going to deal with here have to do with natural logarithms. So when we first learned the inverse power rule, we mentioned that the inverse power rule works for everything except that if you have x to the negative 1 power, because if you raise the power by 1, divide by the new power, you're dividing by 0. So this is why you can't do that. This is because we actually have a special integral that we have. If you have 1 over x, instead of using inverse power rule, we're going to automatically change it into natural log of absolute value of x. The reason why the absolute values are there is because of the domain of natural logs. We talked about that earlier in this class, that the domain has to only be values greater than but not equal to 0, and the absolute value will guarantee you have positive numbers only there going into that. Now likewise, if you have a u that's here, then it goes into ln of u plus c, and we're actually going to be doing the same process with our u substitution we've been talking about before, and essentially you'll end up getting this part here, u prime over u, which allows us to cancel out any x's if there are any in there, leaving us only with 1 over u, which eventually will turn into natural log of u. So with that, let's go ahead and take a look at an example. All right, we've just taken a look at the rules for integrating where you have a natural log. Now you may not know right by looking at the problem that it's going to turn into that. So of course when you start the problem, you're still going to do the same four-step procedure we've already been talking about in this section. Step number one would be you want to identify your u, and as I mentioned earlier, you usually want to pick u that has the higher power if you're talking about positive exponents here. So I want to let u equal the bottom one there, x cubed plus 3x squared plus 4. And then in step number two, I want to take the derivative of both sides. So for here, when I take the derivative, I get 3x squared plus 6x. Derivative of 4 is 0, and don't forget we have a dx on that side. So at this step, I want to solve, right after that, I want to solve for dx. And so when I solve for dx, I get du over this. Now, I notice that this one is in a factored form, so I need to do one of two things. I either need to multiply that part out, or what I'll do here is I'm just going to factor this part that would normally go on the bottom. So this 3x squared plus 6x, I can factor out a 3x from there, and that's going to give me an x plus 2 left over. So now I see here what my dx is going to be, and I'm ready to put it back into my integral. And so now I have x and x plus 2, and I'll be able to see more clearly what's going to cancel out there. If I didn't have it in the factored form, I might not think it canceled out with the top one, so that's why I wanted to go ahead and do this step to see that it does match the top. So I have in the bottom, this whole thing is going to be a u, and then instead of dx, I have du over 3x and then x plus 2. Okay, so at this point, what I notice there is I'll by writing it out this way, I'll be able to get the x and x plus 2's cancel. I'm still going to have a 3 down there, which means that a 1/3 is going to come outside, and I have 1 over u du. And then I'm just going to go ahead and integrate this using the formula that we used before, and this will be my step number 4. When I integrate, I get 1/3. This will turn into a natural log of u plus c. We're just using that formula that we just talked about. The u here is this whole thing, so I'm going to put that back in. So I have natural log of x cubed plus 3x squared plus 4. Plus c. Now, there are some cases where you may not have to include the absolute values, and that's if you know that whatever you have here is always going to be positive no matter what. Like if it was like x squared plus 1 or something like that, we wouldn't need to put the absolute values. You can make them parentheses. But in this case, because you have a cube, we don't know if that could be positive, could be negative, so that's why we are going to include the absolute values in our answer.